Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Brownsburg High School Production Theater again. Before we begin, Peter Ballard asked me to make a few small requests of all of you in attendance. First and foremost, there is absolutely no poverty or videography permitted during the production. We also ask that you turn off all cell phones, or at least put them in airplane mode. Not only can it be distracting the actors and your fellow audience members, it also interferes with the wireless communication system our crew uses to communicate backstage. At this time, please take your phones out and use them.
One, two, three, 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 dance beautifully, Mr.
Mala! Mala! Oh, here you are, Mary.
Oh, George, dear, whatever's the matter?
Matter? This tie, it will not tie. Not around my neck, but around the bedpost, oh yes, but around my neck, oh no, begs to be excused.
Say it again, Mother, say it again.
A little less noise there. Oh, I warn you of this, Mary, that unless this tie goes round my neck, we don't go out to dinner tonight. And if we don't go out to dinner tonight, I never go to the office again. And if I don't go to the office again, you and I starve. And our children will be thrown into the streets.
Let me try, Father dear.
Oh, please, not too tight. I would like to breathe. Oh, wow.
That's better.
Got it? Wendy?
Hooray!
Okay, oh, I got it. Okay, Michael.
Yay. Oh,
nobody starves tonight. My goodness, not on my watch.
Oh,
you're fucking
so silly. John, we don't need to tell Martha, but can you fix it? All right.
I won't take a bath. Nana, I won't take a bath.
Well, go and be bathed at once, sir. Oh, come on now, Michael. No more nonsense, thank you. Oh, Mary, look here. Hair all over my trousers. Clumsy, clumsy.
I'll brush you off, Father dear.
Thank you. Mary, I sometimes think it's a mistake to have a dog for a nurse.
Why, George, Nana is a treasure.
Well, no doubt, but sometimes I have an uneasy feeling that she looks on the children as her puppies.
George, we must keep Nana. I will tell you why. This evening, when I came into the room, I saw a face at the window.
A face at the window? 2 floors up?
It was the face of a little boy. He was trying to get in.
Well, impossible.
It's not the first time I've seen that boy.
Mm-hmm.
The first time was a week ago. I remember because it was Nana's night off. I was sitting by the fire when suddenly I felt a draft as though the window were open. I looked round and I saw that boy in the room. I screamed. Nana came back and sprang at him at once. The boy leapt for the window. Nana closed it quickly, but it was too late to catch him.
I thought so.
But wait.
Okay.
The boy escaped. But his shadow hadn't had time to get out. I hid it, and here it is.
Aha, well. Really, it doesn't look like anyone we know. But he does look a scoundrel.
I think he comes back trying to retrieve his shadow.
I dare say.
But wait, I haven't told you all. The boy was not quite alone. He was accompanied by, I don't know how to describe it. Why, a ball of light, no bigger than my fist, that darted about the room like a living thing.
Oh, that is very unusual.
Oh, George, what can all this mean?
What indeed?
Oh, Nana, what have we there? Oh, the medicine spoon, of
course. I won't take it, Nana.
Oh, come on now, Michael, be a man.
Won't.
I'll get you a lovely stick of candy to take it with.
Oh, Mother, don't pamper him. Michael, when I was your age, I used to take my medicine without a murmur. I used to say, thank you, kind parents, for giving me medicine to make me well. And as an example, I would take mine now, but it seems to have lost the power.
Well, I know where it is, Father.
Oh,
where
is it? When you carry, John,
you'll see the other father.
I've been as quick as I could.
Oh, yes, you have. Wonderfully quick. Oh, precious quick.
Michael, you will see how Father takes it.
Oh, Michael first.
Father first.
It'll make me sick, you know.
I thought you said you took it quite well.
Well, that's not the point. The point is, well, the point is that there's more in my glass than there is in Michael's spoon. And it isn't fair.
Come on, Father.
A little less noise there.
Father, I'm waiting.
Father hasn't taken his.
Oh, Father!
Oh, what do you mean by, oh, Father? Oh, stop that growl, Michael. I meant to take it. I just kissed it. Come on now, to bed, the lot of you. Michael, Wendy, John.
Well, is it all over yet?
Oh, yes, and quite satisfactory.
Father did it!
Father didn't what?
Oh, nothing. Nothing at all. It's the gross. Look, hair all over my trousers again.
Oh, dear.
Oh,
Father, she's crying.
Well, go on, coddle her. Nobody ever coddles me. I'm only the breadwinner. Why would anyone want to coddle me? Why?
George, not so loud. The servants will hear you.
Well, let the whole world hear. I refuse to let that dog lord it in my nursery for 1 hour longer.
Father!
In vain. Your place is downstairs, Nana. Come, Nana.
Remember what I told you about that boy.
Am I the master of this house, or is she? Come, Nana. Come on, Nana. Good Nana. Nice Nana. Witty Nana. Oh, come here, Nana. You're such a good girl. I got you. All right, let's go.
Father, no, please.
Downstairs.
Let her stay.
Be brave, my dears.
He's chaining Nana up.
She's awfully unhappy.
That's not her unhappy bark. It's her bark when she smells danger.
Danger? Wendy, are you sure?
Yes, Mother. Is everything all right?
All is quiet and still. I wish I weren't going out to dinner tonight.
Mother, can't anything harm us after the night lets her live?
No, precious. They are the eyes a mother leaves behind to guard her sleeping children. Now sing your goodnight song and into your beds.
Tender shepherd, tender shepherd, let me help you count your sheep.
One in the meadow, two in the garden, three in the nursery, fast asleep.
Good night, good night, good night.
Tender shepherd, tender shepherd,
tender shepherd.
Asleep. Dear night lights that protect my sleeping children, burn clear and steadfast tonight.
Thank you.
Take! Tink, do come out of that jug. Tink, do you know where they put it? Over there? But which drawer? Ah. Shadow, I'll stick you on with soap. What's the matter with you?
Boy, why are you crying?
What's your name?
Wendy Moira Angela Darling. What's your name?
Peter Pan.
Is that all?
Yes.
Oh, I'm so sorry.
It doesn't matter.
Where do you live?
Second star to the right and straight on till morning.
What a funny address.
No, it isn't.
I mean, is that what they put on your letters?
Don't get any letters.
But your mother gets letters.
Don't have a mother.
Oh, Peter!
Oh, you mustn't touch me.
Why?
No one must ever touch me.
Why not?
I don't know.
No wonder you were crying.
I wasn't crying about that. But I can't get my shadow to stick on.
It has come off? How awful. Why, Peter, you've been trying to stick it on with soap.
Well then.
It must be sewn on.
What is sewn?
You're dreadfully ignorant.
No, I'm not.
I shall have to sew it on for you, my little man.
Thank you. Is it gonna hurt?
Dare say it will hurt a little.
Well, I never cry.
Oh, hold still. Oh. Stop that.
There. It isn't quite itself yet.
Perhaps I should have ironed it.
Wendy, look! My shadow, my very own shadow.
But it's only a shadow.
Yes, but it's all mine. Oh, I'm clever. Oh, the cleverness of me.
And of course, I did nothing. You're conceited.
Conceited? Not me. It's just that I am what I am, and I'm me. When I look at myself and I see in myself all the wonderful things that I see, if I'm pleased with myself, I have every good reason to be. I got a crow.
trick to my shadow to stick to the tip of my toe. I got a crow. I got a brag. I think it's sweet. I have fingers and feet. I can wiggle and wag. I can climb trees and play tag with the breeze in the meadows below. I got a crow.
Now shall I give you a kiss?
If you please. A button. Why, Peter, I shall wear it on this chain around my neck. Peter, how old are you?
I don't know. I ran away from home the day I was born.
Ran away? Why?
Because I heard father and mother talking of what I was to be when I became a man. I want always to be a little boy and to have fun. So I ran away and I've lived 1, 2, 3, 4, a long time among the fairies.
Fairies? You know fairies?
Yes, but they're nearly all dead now.
Why?
You see, Wendy, when the first baby laughed for the first time, the laugh broke into 1,000 pieces, and they all went skipping about, and that was the beginning of fairies. And now, when every new baby is born, its first laugh becomes a fairy.
So there ought to be a fairy for every boy or girl.
Ought to be? Isn't there?
Oh, no. Children know such a lot now. Soon they don't believe, and every time a child says, I don't believe in fairies. There's a fairy somewhere that falls down dead.
Oh, poor things.
Can't think where she has gone to. Tinkerbell, Tink.
Peter, you don't mean to tell me there's an actual live fairy right here in this room?
She came with me. Wendy, I believe I shut her up in that drawer. Hold on. Well, you needn't say that. Well, I'm very sorry. Well, how could I know you were in that drawer? Tink, this lady wishes you were her fairy.
Oh. What does she say?
She says you're a great ugly girl and she's mine. Tink, you know you can't be my fairy because I'm a gentleman and you're a lady.
What did she say?
She said... She's quite a common girl, you know.
Stop. Peter, where do you live?
Way out there.
How do you find your way home?
You just follow all the golden arrows.
Where do they lead you?
It's a secret place.
Oh, please tell me.
Would you believe me if I told you?
Promise!
For sure?
For sure.
Time is never planned. It's not on any chart. You must find it with your heart. Never, never land. It might be miles beyond the moon, or right there where you stand. Just keep an open mind, and then suddenly you'll find. Never, never land. You'll have a treasure if you stay there, more precious far than gold. For once you have found your way there, you can never, never grow old. And that's my home where dreams are born. And time is never planned. Just think of lovely things and your heart will fly on wings forever. In never, never land.
What does it look like, Peter?
It's an island, Wendy.
A large one?
No, quite small and nicely crammed, with hardly any space between one adventure and another. And it's summer and winter and spring and fall all at the same time on different parts of the island.
Oh, how I wish I could see it!
You can. Just close your eyes tight. Now, what do you see?
I see a pool of lovely pale colors.
Squeeze them tighter.
Yes.
And the pool will take on different shapes, and the colors become brighter. So bright that in a moment they'll go on fire. And in that moment, just before they do...
I see it!
That's it, Wendy. That's my island.
You'll have a treasure if you stay there. More precious far than gold. For once you have found your way there, you can never, never grow old. And that's my home where dreams are born, and time is never planned. Just think of lovely things and your heart fly on wings forever. In never, never land.
Oh, never land! What fun it must be! Who else lives there, Peter?
The Lost Boys.
And who are they?
They are the children who fall out of their prams when the nurse is looking the other way. If they aren't claimed in 7 days, they're sent far away to Neverland. I'm Captain.
Oh, what fun it must be!
Yes, but we're rather lonely. You see, Wendy, we have no female companionship.
Are none of the others girls?
No, Girls, you know, are much too clever to fall out of their prams.
Oh, Peter, it's perfectly lovely the way you talk about girls. You may give me a kiss.
Well, I thought you would want it back.
Peter, I didn't mean a kiss. I meant a thimble.
What is that?
Well, it goes like this.
Ow! What is it?
It was exactly as if someone were pulling on my hair. Oh,
that's Tink. I never knew her so naughty before.
Stop. What does she say?
She says she will do that every time I give you a thimble.
Why?
Why, Tink?
What did she say?
She said... Again!
She's very impertinent! Peter, why were you sitting outside our nursery window?
To hear the stories. None of us knows any stories.
Oh, how perfectly awful.
Oh, Wendy, your mother was telling you such a lovely story.
What was it?
It was about the prince, and he couldn't find the lady who wore the glass slipper.
Peter, that's Cinderella. He found her, and they were happily ever after.
I'm glad.
Where are you going?
Tell the other boys.
Oh, don't go, Peter. I know lots of stories.
Do you?
Oh, Peter, the stories I could tell the boys.
Come on, we'll fly.
Fly? You can fly?
Oh, Wendy, come with me. How we should all respect you. You could tuck us in at night and make pockets for us.
None of us has any pockets.
It's awfully fascinating. Would you teach John and Michael to fly, too?
If you like.
Oh, John! Michael! Wake up! There's a boy here who's going to teach us to fly!
Yay!
And I'll get up at once. Quick! Out of lights! Hide! Someone's coming!
Think about...
There, you see? They are perfectly safe and sound, asleep in bed.
Now, no more. Come along, you naughty dog.
Come on!
Can you really fly?
I'll teach you.
How lovely to fly!
I'll teach you how to jump on the wind's back and away we'll go! Wendy, when you're sleeping in your silly bed, you might be flying about with me saying funny things to the stars.
How do you do it?
You just think lovely, wonderful thoughts, and up you go!
How sweet!
I'm sweet, I'm sweet. I'm flying.
Flying!
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 Look at me, way up high, suddenly, here am I, I'm flying. I'm flying.
Flying!
I can soar, I can weave, and what's more, I'm not even trying. High up and as light as I can be. I must be a sight lovely to see. I'm flying.
Flying!
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 Nothing will stop me now, higher still. Look at how I can zoom around. Way up off the ground, I'm flying. I fly and I'm all over the place. You try and you fall flat on your face. I'm flying.
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 Over bed, over chair, duck your head, clear the air, oh what lovely fun. Watch me, everyone, take a look at me and see how easily it's done. I'm flying! You like it?
Oh, yes, Peter, yes!
Want to learn how?
Please, do it, Peter!
First, I must blow the fairy dust on you. Now think,
fishing.
Hopscotch.
Candy.
Picnics.
Summer.
Candy.
Sailing.
Flowers.
Candy.
Lovelier thoughts, Michael. Neverland?
How lovely!
There are pirates and Indians.
Pirates?
Indians? Oh,
let's go at once!
Get ready! You ready?
Ready!
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 Don't forget, don't be slow. Ready, set, here we go. Wendy, Michael, John, take a bow. Come on! Hurry up and follow me, for I will soon be gone. Hold on to your hat, John.
You hold on to my hand, I hold on to Teddy.
Get ready.
Here we go.
There you are.
Hold on tight, Michael.
Teddy bear.
I'll take you to Neverland. You can meet all the lost boys.
How many are there?
There are 22 of them, Wendy.
22?
Yes. And there are Indians.
Are they nice Indians?
I don't know. I don't see them much.
Oh!
What about the pirates?
What? The pirates are scary.
They're smelly.
Especially Captain Hook.
Captain Hook?
Yes.
Who is that?
But he's not very smart.
Thank you. Did we catch her?
Look.
Oh, no, we found this!
Peter, come back yet, Slightly?
No, twin.
I wish Peter would come back.
So do we.
I'm always scared of the pirates and Indians when Peter's not here to help us.
I wonder what's taking him so long. Maybe he's waiting to hear the end of Cinderella.
Cinderella! Not knowing anything about my mother, I'm fond thinking that she's just like Cinderella.
My mother was fonder of me than your mothers were of you.
No, she wasn't!
Yes, she was. Peter had to make up names for all of you, but my mother wrote my name in the clothes I was lost in. Slightly soiled. That's my
that
name.
That doesn't change anything. My mom's still...
upon us. Do you want to lose your scalps? Put me down.
That is true, Captain. Shall I after him and tickle him with Johnny Corkscrew? Johnny's a silent fellow.
Not now, Smee. He is only one, and I want to mischief all the boys. They must live around here somewhere. Scatter and look for them. Scatter and look for them. Most of all, I want their cap. Peter Pan. Oh. 'Twas he cut off me arm. Oh, I have long waited to shake hands with this. Oh, I'll tear him.
I have oft heard you say your hook was worth a score of hands for combing the hair and other homely uses.
I see. If I were a mother, I'd pray that my children be born with this. Oh. Instead of that. Oh. But... Pan flung me hand to a crocodile that happened to be passing by.
I have oft noticed your strange dread of... Oh, crocodiles.
Oh, Captain, what are you doing?
Not of all crocodiles, but of that one crocodile. He liked me hand so much that he has followed me ever since. From land to land, from sea to sea.
Your hat?
Get it. Pick it up.
It's a day.
I don't know. They should look like they have instruments. I don't know.
I don't know.
Anyways, from land to land, from sea to sea, he follows the ship. Licking his lips
for the rest of me in a word, sort of a compliment.
Well, I wanted not just compliments.
Your hat keeps falling off.
Get it! Oh.
Captain,
perfectly fine.
My hat is bigger. I wear the pants. Anyways, I want Peter Pan. Snee, that crocodile would have gotten me long ere this. If he could have gotten me and crept up upon me unawares, but by some lucky chance, he swallowed a clock.
A clock?
Aye, and it goes on. Tick, tock, tick, tock, tick, tock within him. And so, before he can reach me, I hear the tick and bolt. What? I heard it tick 6 times within him.
You know, someday that clock will run out, and then he'll get you.
Aye.
And that is a fear that haunts me.
Smee?
What is the matter, Captain?
This seat's hot. Oh! It's very hot! Odds, bods, hammers, and tongs, I'm burning!
Captain! Smee!
Help me!
Oh,
my bum!
Captain,
my
Captain.
Rear! Oh, my rear is
Captain.
On the fire! It is set ablaze! It is blazing! Get out of my way! My bum is on fire!
Captain!
You are so slow, my bummy! He's a blip!
Will you at least put your hat back on? Stay.
Why is it on fire? The chimney. Peter and the boys must be living underground.
Listen. I want to listen.
They say that Peter Pan is away from home.
Put my hat back on.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Tighter.
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 Tighter. You put it on way too easily. Now call back the band.
The band. Oh, of course.
I must think. Inspire me.
Well, what?
Play, you dogs.
I don't think you heard me the first time. I said, what tempo, Captain?
Tempo, tempo, tempo. A tango.
A tango. Maestro, a tango. Unwrap your plan, Captain.
A cake quite large, and fill each layer in between with icing mixed with poison, till it turns a temptation. We'll place it near the house, just where the boys are sure to come. When being greedy, they won't care to your question.
So keep up your...
No mother sweet, no one to show in their mistake. Won't know it's dangerous to eat. So jump and reach a cake!
Oh, Captain! I'm okay, Captain!
Oh, don't worry about it. Rub some dirt on it. And so la 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 la
in one. By one, they'll die. Hooray! Bravo, Bravo! 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 Oh, well, thank you. Thank you. Horrid little boys, that time has come. The cock! The cock! I hear him ticking! Protect me, Smee! Protect me!
Oh, thank you very much. Oh, Captain, don't leave me!
What's that noise?
It's so quiet.
Shh. Listen to Tiger Lily. When on warpath, shh.
Wugga wugga wigwam!
Thank you.
They're gone. I pinky promise.
Indian proverb, when in doubt, run!
Well, that's silly.
Here, boys, let's shoot the Wendy.
Aye, shoot it quick, bows and arrows.
Out of the way, I'll shoot it. I killed it. Peter will be so pleased with me.
Wait, I don't know when three is. I don't know when that is, though.
There you go, Michael. Greetings, boys. I'm back, and I have a great surprise.
So do we.
We killed a big white bird.
Wendy? With an arrow in her heart? Oh, this isn't a bird. It's a lady.
A lady?
I was bringing her here to be our mother, and you have killed her. Whose arrow?
Mine, Peter.
Oh, dastard hand. Oh, I cannot strike. Something stops me.
Look at her arm.
She lives! See, the arrow struck against this. It's a kiss I gave her.
Ooh, I remember kisses. Let me see. That's a kiss.
Are you asleep, Wendy? Well, don't you want to get up and play?
What kind of play? What do we do with Wendy?
Yeah, let's carry her down into the house.
No, no! You mustn't touch her. That wouldn't be sufficiently respectful.
Sufficiently respectful.
I know. We'll build a house around her. I have a plan. We'll need lots of wood, need lots of leaves, need lots of paint. But hush, 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 hush. Let's be quiet as a mouse and build a lovely little house for Wendy. All for Wendy. She's come to stay. Home upon the wall, a welcome mat down in the hall for Wendy, so that Wendy won't go away. Oh, what pleasure she'll bring to us, make us pockets and sing to us, tell us stories we've been longing to hear over and over. She'll be waiting at door. We won't be lonely anymore since Wendy, lovely Wendy's here to say.
We have a mother.
Bring the best of what we have. Come on, little boys. Come over here with me. Look at her. Wow.
Peter,
watch out. Oh, thank you.
We have a mother.
we have a mother.
Oh, this looks great. She'll bring to us, make us pockets, and sing to us, tell us stories we've been longing to hear over and over. She'll be waiting at the door, we won't be lonely anymore since Wendy.
Lovely Wendy's here to stay. We have a mother, last we have a mother.
She'll be our mother. It's nice to have a mother.
Wendy's here to
pleased.
Lovely, darling house. And we're your children.
Please.
I'd love to be your mother. Yes. Provided Peter will be the father.
Oh.
All right. As long as it's only make-believe.
La 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 la.
Children, children! I'm sure this cake is much too damp and rich for you. Now, into the house. Before I put you to bed, we'll have just enough time to finish the story of Cinderella.
Have found a mother.
What's a mother?
Nothing. What's a mother with you? I must think.
What tempo, Captain?
A tarantella.
Oh. Wait, a tarantula?
No. A tarantella.
Oh.
Maestro. Yes, I see a spark, a gleam, a glimmer of a plan, which may perhaps I could redeem me on Earth. Kidnap when he sees the boys, and you'll have Hook to thank. But when the time is right, you'll see the children walk the plank. When was such a princely plot concocted by another to murder all the boys and keep the Wendy for a mother? Hey, tra-la-la-la, 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 and keep the Wendy for a mother. Hey!
Brother!
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 Yo-ho!
Yo-ho!
To ship!
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 To the ship.
Oh. 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 Oh.
Wugga ostrich!
Wugga ostrich!
Here's and each a murderous crook. In deep, pursue them!
Are you ready for today's lesson?
Yes, Peter!
Then listen to your teacher. Repeat after me. I won't grow up.
I won't grow up.
I don't want to go to school.
I don't want to go to school.
Just to learn to be a parrot.
Just to learn to be a parrot.
And recite a silly rule.
And recite a silly rule.
If growing up means it would be beneath my dignity to climb a tree,
I'll never grow up, never grow up, never grow up. Not me.
Not I.
Not me.
Not me!
I won't grow up.
I won't grow up.
I don't want to wear a tie.
I don't want to wear a tie.
Or a serious expression.
Or a serious expression.
In the middle of July.
In the middle of July.
And if it means I must prepare to shoulder burdens with a worried air,
I'll never grow up, never grow up, never grow up.
Not me.
Not I.
Not me!
So there. Never gonna be a man.
I won't
like to see somebody try
and make me
anyone who wants to try
and make me
turn into a man. Catch me if you can. I won't grow up.
I won't grow up.
Not a penny will I pinch.
Not a penny will I pinch.
I will never grow a mustache.
I will never grow a mustache.
Or a fraction of
an inch.
Or a fraction of an inch. Cause growing up is awfuler than all the awful things that ever were. I'll never grow up, never grow up, never grow up.
No, sir.
Not I.
Not me. So there.
I won't grow up.
I won't grow up.
I will never even try.
I will never even try.
I will do what Peter tells me.
I will do what Peter tells me.
And I'll never ask him why.
And I'll never ask him why.
We won't grow up.
We won't grow up.
We will never grow a day.
We will never grow a day.
And if someone tries to make us,
and if someone tries to make us,
we'll simply run away.
We'll simply run away.
I won't grow up.
I won't grow up.
No, I promise that I won't.
No, I promise that I won't.
I will stay a boy forever.
Stay a boy forever.
If I don't,
and be banished if I don't,
and Neverland will always be the home of youth and joy and liberty. I'll never grow up, never grow up, never grow up.
Not me.
Not me.
Not me.
Not me.
No, sir. No.
You spalpeens, move! The captain ordered us to tie her to the tree and leave her for the wolves. The tree is over here, you fools!
To the tree with her mate!
Not so rough, Starkey. Roughish, but not so rough.
Oh, poor Tiger Lily!
What was that?
Ahoy there, you lubbers!
It's the captain. He must be close by.
I tied the redskin to the tree, Captain.
Set her free.
But, Captain...
Cut her bonds or I'll plunge me hook in you.
Oh, we'd better do as the captain says.
Aye, aye, Captain. Untie her. You see the captain?
Ahoy there!
Oh, it is the captain!
Captain, is all well?
All is very well. Where is the redskin? Where is the red skin?
We let her go, Captain.
Let her go?
'Twas your orders, Captain.
Oh, you called for us to let her go, Captain.
Brimstone and gall, what cousining is he? Spirit that haunts this forest tonight, dost hear me?
Odds, bods, hammer and tongs, I hear you.
Speak, stranger. Who are you?
I am Hook.
Hook?
Captain of the Jolly Roger.
If you are Hook, then who am I?
A codfish.
A codfish?
Codfish. Codfish. Have we been captain all this time by a codfish?
It's lowering to our pride.
Yeah.
Don't desert me, bullies! Speak, stranger. Have you another name?
Yes.
Is it a vegetable?
No.
Mineral?
No.
Animal?
Yes.
Have you another voice?
Yes.
It's a lady. It's a beautiful lady. Oh, my mysterious lady, what is your name? My mysterious lady, from whence have you came? Answer my plea, who may ye be? Mysterious lady, what is your name? Take off that veil and let me see your face. Why hide your beauty beneath that ton of lace? Take off that veil and let me see your face. Why hide your beauty beneath that ton of lace? Take off the veil and let me see your face. Why hide your beauty beneath that ton of lace? What's your secret?
La, 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 la.
Tell your secret.
La, 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 la.
Speak, oh, speak, oh, speak, I pray you. Tell me, oh, tell me. Nay.